Tonight, I'll be making some crinkle cookies with my sister.
Order, guys, here's the news. It is the Forest Hill School Lip Sync Challenge. Choose one of those four songs, get your whānau involved, dress up, record for at least a minute or the whole song if you want, and send it to Matua J. We look forward to seeing what you come up with.
And she has written many stories like The Gruffalo, Room on a Broom. So today I'm reading The a Squash and a Squeeze. Hope you enjoy the story. A little old lady lived all by herself, with a table and chairs and a jug on the shelf. A wise old man heard her grumble and grouse, "There's not enough room in my house. Wise old man, won't you help me please? My house is a squash and a squeeze." "Take in your hen," said the wise old man.
"Take in my hen? What a curious plan."
Well, the hen laid an egg on the fireside rug and flapped around the room, knocking over the jug. The little old lady cried, "What shall I do? It was pokey for one and it's tiny for two. My nose has a tickle and there's no room to sneeze. My house is a squash and a squeeze." And she said, "Wise old man, won't you help me please? My house is a squash and a squeeze." "Take in your goat," said the wise old man.
"Take in my goat? What a curious plan."
Well, the goat chewed the curtains and trod on the egg, then sat down to nibble the table leg. The little old lady cried, "Glory be! It was tiny for two, it's titchy for three. The hen pecks the goat and the goat's got fleas. My house is a squash and a squeeze." And she said, "Wise old man, won't you help me please? My house is a squash and a squeeze." "Take in your pig," said the wise old man.
"Take in my pig? What a curious plan."
So she took in her pig, who kept chasing the hen and raiding the larder again and again. The little old lady cried, "Stop, I implore. It was Titchy for three, and it's Teeny for four. Even the pig in the larder agrees, my house is a squash and a squeeze. And she said, wise old man, won't you help me, please? My house is a squash and a squeeze.
Take in your cow, said the wise old man.
Take in my cow? What a curious plan. Well, the cow took one look and charged straight at the pig, then jumped on the table and tapped out a jig. The little old lady cried, heavens alive! It was Tiny for four, it's Weeny for five. It's I'm tearing my hair out, I'm down on my knees. My house is a squash and a squeeze. And she said, wise old man, won't you help me please? My house is a squash and a squeeze.
Take them all out, said the wise old man. But then I'll be back where I first began. So she opened the window and out flew the hen. That's better. At last I can sneeze again. She shooed out the goat and she shoved out the pig. My house is beginning to feel pretty big. She huffed and she puffed and she pushed out the cow. She just look at my house. It's enormous now. Thank you, old man, for the work you have done. It was Weeny for five. It's gigantic for one. There's no need to grumble and there's no need to grouse. There's plenty of room in my house. And now she's full of phonics and fiddle-dee-dees. It isn't a squash and it isn't a squeeze. Yes, she's full of frolics and fiddle-dee-dees. It isn't a squash or a squeeze. There you go. I hope you enjoyed that story. Can you see how clever the wise old man was, making her realise how grateful she should be for what she already had? Also, I hope you noticed all the rhyming words in this story. Julia Donaldson loves rhyming words, and her books are great for listening to rhyme. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye for now.